with you a little bit more on Kor-Drath. Got some new golden opens. So anyway, see if I can do this without tasting it this time. It's Sunday and a snowy day in Maine. What better day to paint? Titanium white sap green. Can darken up this green with a little bit of ultramarine blue. So I'm going to hit the foliage first, or at least the closest foliage. And that is not blue, but that's my normal colors. Let's see. Here's the blue. That's mostly just to tone the green. And then we're having a Honda focus. This doesn't seem to be focusing all that well, does it? And that's Eli.
Huh?
Who said he didn't want to live stream with me, but apparently he does.
Like Pan. Oh.
What am I painting?
I don't call it what I got.
You don't know what to call it?
Yeah.
Kor-Drath. That's what they call it.
Keep your cheek on. To the center, to the cell.
It is snow.
To the cell. Next year. Next year.
Next year.
That's a day. Last day. Very last day. Oh, what took me for free?
Layers, going down the layers. And I should be back over here showing you what I'm painting. I used to think painting should be done like in a day. It's taken me a long time to realize that that's false thinking. They take however long they need to be taken. Sometimes they're quicker, sometimes they're not. I think Bob Ross had it right, because it's really about the joy. If it doesn't bring you joy, you're not doing something. Going to try to make this stream about an hour long, because I'm pretty much interrupting the family who want to be doing laundry. But I wanted to put a little more time in on this painting so that everyone could see. I'm sure there's a lot of painters out there that are more experienced than me that don't need to see it. There's a lot of painters out there that are beginners that need to see that they're not alone in the struggle. Using a lot of the thinner . So I'll use a little bit of the mixture, I'll hit it with the thinner, and then I'll come back in with a little bit of thinner over the top because I've already got a base layer down and I'm not worried about that.
For dinner,
for hot. I'm not sure what the rules on music are. Or if I can just play music and it'll pick it up while I'm wearing the earphones. But got a couple of ideas of music that's in the public domain. Give it a shot. I don't know if anyone's even listening to this or will be. So, this is all old public domain music. Let's see if I'm good with it, or you can hear it at all, or whatever. Guess the way I find out is if they give me a strike, right?
It's okay. You're not.
I'll have to see if this is actually making sound for anybody else. Hopefully everyone that's watched this has gone over and checked out the Kor-Drath campaign. Andy's got a few pages up free on his site that you can read to give you a head start. It's pretty barbaric, which is what I like about it. And it's a number four brush, if anyone's curious.
then hung up. Shocky.
Well, you can see that every time I go over the color, it darkens the colors that are already laid down. I could use this blending agent to blend them all in. But I actually want to keep that kind of a ridge look going on. Because it's not really a fern, but it's a fantasy tree, but it's intended to take its roots from a fern. No pun intended. So basically, when I get done with this, I'm probably going to kill the stream. Nobody showed up. So nobody will be missing it. And I'm probably going to paint a little bit more off stream, get some of this done. It'd probably take forever to just paint it on stream, so. That is not the plan. The plan is to give you an overview of what I'm doing, like how I'm layering it in, how I'm mixing between colors, or hue if you want, and using the just thinning agent and mixing agent to kind of spread that color thinly all over the place. Like I said, I'm painting in layers, so what I want to do is build up a tone so that it separates it a little bit. I want a little bit more shadow where the hand is. And I'm going to darken some of the ridge lines there. But I don't want this piece here to overpower the whole thing. Because Kor-Drath is the main subject. So, got about 10 minutes left. And I'm going to use that to continue to try to show you how I'm layering stuff in to darken it up. Also trying to get a leaf shape, a flatter edge. Thank you. So this is a mixture of the ultramarine blue and the sap green. And I add more blue where I want it darker. And thin it out where I don't. Oh, hey, somebody showed up. Did you see the last one, Brett? Where I toned his body, did a little bit of gray work. Yeah, last song, yeah. Kind of ended it with the grays. That was last night. Got some new paints today. I figured I'd play with them, but still, there's so much more to be done. I'm trying to get the scale done. I don't want it to just be like dark in one spot. I'm gonna have a feel like it's real. Not trying to make it super realistic, but three-dimensional. Oh, because they're new. Like, I don't necessarily. Last night I dropped my brush and actually hit the paint. And I went to open more paint and stuck that tag in my mouth and it was covered in paint. I don't normally. These are new. So I've got brushes for watercolors, I've got brushes for oils, and then I've got brushes for acrylics. And watercolor and acrylic, to a degree, are kind of interchangeable, but not so when it comes to oils. Water and oil don't mix. So I do want to have something that I can distinguish it a little bit with, but not necessarily scoop the paint up. Don't taste good, by the way. Don't recommend it. Sitting there with a paper towel trying to get the colors out of my mouth. Dumb mistake. I knew I dropped the brush. I just didn't know it went in the color. I knew it was near the color. I just didn't know how near, apparently. How is the character coming along? You progress on Skeletor's evil half brother, or whatever he is. Blew up in here. Gotta say, that's a fun idea for a project. A henchman too, huh? Please tell me it's not Beastman or a derivative. Yeah, right? I don't know why anybody would complain about you having an art project with your kid. They must be no fun. I wish I could do that with my kids. They either don't want to, or they have delusions of grandeur, will never accomplish what they're trying to do. That seems pretty simple, pretty fun, pretty inexpensive. It's not like you're out buying motorcycles or any of that crap. Pie in the sky idea. Everybody's starting YouTube channels, like everybody's streaming. If they're not, then they're missing out, or their old buddy that is. You can't go into a Walmart without finding streaming equipment. And Walmart's everywhere. So weird the angle that I have to have this camera at. I'm literally turning this sideways or diagonally to have it look straight. That's hugely diagonal. This would be straight up and down. Have you started your channel yet? Like, other than just the couple of videos that you had? Yeah, I'm almost to that point. Yeah, it's really weird. Like, actually, you have to have 50 subscribers to be able to live stream from your phone. Which is what I set out to do at the beginning. Figured I could do that. And I started seeing that kind of had to jump through a few hoops to get there. Like, really, that's, no, thank you. I don't necessarily want to stream from my phone. Hopefully this channel will benefit everyone. That's the whole, the idea. Are you going to start a separate one then?
Well, my camera. Mm-hmm. Watch your hand, okay? Mm-hmm. Oh my god, they are. Oh my god, now.
What?
Oh my god, they are. Wow.
Can you hear still standing? I don't know yet.
Can you hear them? Can you hear the family in the background? Trying to figure out how much this mic picks up. This would be awesome if I didn't have to interrupt everything. Got this little kind of curtained off place. I'd say right in the middle of everything, but everything in this place is right in the middle of everything.
So, Sean? Same old.
Welcome, baby.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, so I'm gonna kill this stream. It's almost dinner time. I'll be painting for a little bit after that. That's where it is at the end of today. Get straight.
I'm not going to do that.
Have a good night.